guys, what's going on? Making that push into Lakeport now, or out of Lakeport, sorry. Okeechobee's in reach, and just making that push up towards Okeechobee. Actually, hopefully get back on some real trails up by Yates Marsh, what have you. Stayed North Lakeport last night. A lot of road walking. And got there. There was Beck's Country Store. Hydrated up. Sat around. Just put camp on the dike. And stayed there last night. Probably stay at a Buckhead Ridge tonight. Then have a nice easy day in Okeechobee tomorrow morning, resupply, and probably make it to Yates Marsh campsite tomorrow night. Kind of the itinerary, I guess. Hopefully in Okeechobee somewhere find some time to upload some videos to YouTube. Some Wi-Fi. Get these last couple of segments updated for you guys. So far this morning, dike walking or canal walking, whatever, has actually been pretty nice. It's almost trail-like for the first time in days, it seems like. So. It's actually nice to be on something that is almost like a trail, besides a blacktop or a bike path. So I'm suspecting that we have trails like this the whole way to Okeechobee. Looking at the guidebook, kind of look like that. So I'm pretty excited. Do a resupply in Okeechobee for 4 days or so. We'll see how much food I have when I get there. And my good friend Bob McCabe's dropping me in some stuff to River Ranch Resort in Wayside and River Ranch, Florida. And gonna drop me up some stuff to save me money from buying it at the general store there, because I hear they're pretty expensive. But he's just gonna, drop me in a few essential items there, which is awesome. Thanks a lot, buddy. That'll get me to Christmas, and probably do a convenience store resupply at Christmas. I've decided to take the eastern route around Orlando. Initially, my plan was the western route, because I live there, many of you guys know, and just picking up my shoes and a resupply there. But I said, talk to my mom, and she's actually going to meet me at the 88 store in Ocala and drop off my new shoes for me, and some stuff like that, a resupply. But that means I got to get an extra 100 miles out of these shoes, which, knock on wood, are holding up pretty good. Honestly, a little better than I thought they would. So I figured if they bite the dust between now and then, get a cheapy pair at Walmart or somewhere to hold me over until Ocala, and take it from there. But like I said, hike's going good this morning. We've got a 17 and a half mile day today. Give or take. I think the highway sign said 23 in Okeechobee. Trail miles. I think we got to tack on a couple. So we're planning it out to where we're right there on the outskirts of Okeechobee. And just walk in tomorrow. Get that done. Get the resupply and all that stuff out of the way. And, you know, other than that, going good. Feet are hurting from all the road walking. But every hiker that we come across, and from the Facebook updates and everything else, it's pretty common. We're not the only two on the trail with hurting feet right now. We're pretty much all hurt in the feet department. So it's okay. I count my lucky stars. My feet aren't really hurting too bad right now. They're fine. I think that has to do with change of terrain, actually being back on some type of off-road trip. Still in full exposure. Probably going to be that way till after Okeechobee. Not much shade. No shade at all, really. You know, so it has its challenges, for sure. But it's just walking. And every day a little closer to Fort Pickens. So I'll talk to you guys a little bit from Okeechobee and hopefully get some of these videos uploaded for you. I think I've got about 3 of them on the phone right now that need to get uploaded. So I'll get working on that in Okeechobee for you guys. And thanks for following me. It's nice having you guys out there commenting, liking, and I look forward to your comments, and I appreciate it. Thanks, guys. I'll talk to you in Okeechobee.